Hello, this is Frank Gaillard from Radiopedia.org, and today in another episode in our stroke series, we're going to examine the phenomenon of a CT fogging. Let's start off by looking at a case. This patient presented 2 days following onsets of right-sided weakness with a well-demarcated low-density region in the superior division of the left middle cerebral artery territory. Note that the chordate head and lentiform nucleus are spared, suggesting that the most likely embolus lodged in an M2 branch, sparing the M1 branch from which the lenticulostriate perforators originate. The patient was scanned once more 7 days later, and much to the confusion of the treating physicians, the brain had returned to normal, with apparent return of normal grey-white matter differentiation. Despite this, the patient had not improved. This is a typical timing and appearance of a CT fogging. When one sees it, however, it's worthwhile asking a couple of questions. Firstly, is this the right patient? After all, if you were to accidentally scan the wrong patient, then of course it would appear that they had not had an infarct. Another worthwhile question to ask is, are the dates correct? If there has been a much longer delay, or more importantly, if you're looking at a CT obtained earlier than the stroke, then of course the appearances would be normal. Another trap is that in fact the lesion did not represent an infarct, but rather represented edema from an adjacent tumour, in which case if the patient had received dexamethasone, the edema may have dramatically reduced, although you would expect still to see some underlying abnormality. Similarly, if the cause of the hypotenuation was that of cerebritis, then perhaps antibiotics could have improved the appearances sufficiently to result in a near-normal CT scan. Once you've satisfied yourself that these are not viable options, then the diagnosis is that of CT fogging, which represents a transient return of infarcted brain to a near-normal appearance on CT. CT fogging is seen in up to 50% of cases if serial scans are obtained. However, typically in the setting of an acute infarct, scans are obtained over the first few days to evaluate for swelling and secondary hemorrhage, and then not again for quite some time, usually missing the time period at which CT fogging occurs. Classically, CT fogging is seen during the second and third week following an infarct. A number of processes have been implicated, including migration into the infarcted tissues of lipid-laden macrophages, proliferation of capillaries, a decrease in the overall amount of edema, and cortical lamina necrosis. If in doubt of the diagnosis, the easiest way to confirm that this represents CT fogging is to administer contrast, as the cortex will usually demonstrate vivid ribbon-like cortical enhancement. Alternatively, an MRI can also demonstrate similar features. This same patient was scanned a week later still with MR and demonstrates the vivid cortical enhancement on post-contrast T1 sequences. Non-contrast T1 sequences demonstrate some intrinsic high T1 signal in keeping with cortical lamina necrosis, and there is some residual high T2 signal on flare, although note that there is no significant positive mass effect. So in summary, CT fogging occurs typically 2 to 3 weeks following an ischemic infarct, and results in the return of the infarcted tissue to a near-normal appearance on non-contrast CT. It's important to realize that this does not represent recovery, but rather is merely an artifact. When presented with this, and especially if clinicians do not believe your assessment, this can be confirmed with contrast studies. You can, of course, read more about the fogging phenomenon on radiopedia.org.